Find the surface area of the solid, include units. This is kind of a complicated shape, so what do you do here? Well, your goal is going to be to find the area of each face and then just add them all together. So let's see. I'm going to first find the area of the base, which is this large one right here. And it's kind of weird shaped, so I guess there are two different ways you could do this. One way is you could pretend it's a whole big rectangle and find that area, and then find the area of the small rectangle here and subtract that. Or you can divide this shape into smaller shapes that you can easily find the area of and then add them all together. Well, for me, I'm going to go ahead and find area of the entire rectangle and then subtract the small rectangle. So the base area is going to be 20 inches times 16 inches, and then minus the area of this small rectangle here. Now I know it's 6 inches here, but we don't know this one. You can find that out though by subtraction. See, the whole length on the bottom is 20 inches, and you have 10 here, and then plus 3, so plus this should make 20. So basically we can just do 20 and then minus the 10 and minus the 3, or minus the 13. So that's going to be 7. So this guy is going to be 7 inches. So to subtract this small rectangle, it's going to be minus 7 inches times 6 inches. That's going to be the area of the base. So let's figure what that is. So we have 20 times 16 and minus 7 times 6. And my calculator knows order of operations, so I can just type it in like this. You may have to do yours separately and then subtract at the end. In other words, do 20 times 16, then 7 times 6, and then subtract those two numbers. So 278 . Okay, so the base area is 278 square inches. And there are two of these bases. There's this one in the front and another one in the back. So I can say we're going to have two of these 278 square inches so far. And now we need to find out the area of all the faces going along the sides. And let's count how many there are. There should be one for each side. So there's one here, then two, three, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So there are 8 lateral faces. So I want to find the area of all 8 of these rectangles. Now keep in mind that the height here of this solid is 4 inches. So every side is going to be something by 4. So the bottom one is going to be 20 inches by 4 inches. Which is 80 square inches. And then this guy over here on the right side is going to be 4 inches by 16 inches, or 16 by 4, however you want to do it. And then this little guy up here is going to be 3 inches by 4 inches. Which is 12 square inches. And this one here, this is the tricky one. You can't even see it. But you have to apply the same measurement over here for 6 inches. So it's going to be 6 inches by 4 inches. Which is 24 square inches. And this guy along the bottom of the indentation is going to be 7 by 4. Is 28 square inches. And then there's this guy over here, 6 inches high, and then by 4 inches again. And then this one here, 10 inches, is going to be 10 inches by 4 inches. And then finally, this one over here is 16 inches by 4 inches. Okay, so I went all the way around, and I'm just going to count. There should be 8 of them. So let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Great. So now we're just going to add all these. We have two of these 278 square inches, and then plus all these guys that we found individually, that'll be the total surface area. We know it's 2 times 278. And then it'll be plus, and then all these other ones, 80 plus 64 plus 12 plus 24 plus 28 plus 24 plus 40 plus 64. 892. Square inches.